good evening to you all. I am truly honored and humbled, actually, to be here with you all, receiving the Global Environmental Award. I would like to thank very deeply the Goldman Foundation and the jurors for their choice. And I would like to thank all the people who have helped along these years for the cause of the BioBio. Many of them are present here today, but it would be too long to list them. Now, the timing for this award is so amazing that without wanting to sound ungrateful to the Goldmans or the jurors, I would like to say that I feel that behind the award is the caressing hand of Mother Earth and of the BioBio itself. And the timing is so amazing for the BioBio, is so amazing for the BioBio campaign, for me personally in many ways, but also for the whole Chilean environmental movement. You saw the video, you saw fleeting glimpses of what we have been trying to save. During the last years, really, I have felt sometimes that we are involved in a kind of like a science fiction story. Some human beings, you know, flesh and bones, stardust, trying to save parts of the earth, a river, a lake, a forest, a bay, for life. And other human beings, same flesh and bones, same stardust, trying to use these places violently to exploit them for money. So our struggles here really transcend the local, transcend the river and the forest. We are fighting for dear, beautiful life all together, all over the world, together with many wonderful persons, such as the other prize recipients who are present here today. In Chile, in spite of appearances, the situation is quite difficult in many, many ways. Last week, just before I came to the States, our country finally finished promulgating its first environmental legislation in our history. And from our point of view, it is not precisely an environmentally wise legislation. It is, more than anything else, a system for environmental impact assessment. And we all know by now how things tend to go with environmental impact assessments. And we also know by now that more than laws, we need really the will, the wisdom, the culture, the love. We are absolutely convinced that in a genuine democracy, a large destructive dam could not be built today. So, using non-violent means, we are fighting for life, we are fighting for the environment, but we are also fighting for democracy. Finally, I would like to ask you, to invite you, if you are willing, for 5 seconds, to project our hearts and our minds, our consciousness, towards Chile, towards the BioBio, towards the South, like a good, scented ocean wind that pushes away, that dispels greed and ignorance, so that we can all help the BioBio to keep flowing as freely as possible in spite of the first dam that was already built, and so that we can help the Pehuenche to keep blessing the river and the earth with their rooted culture. Thank you so very much. We are all one. Thank you. Thank you very much.